guess I was wrong about you catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Don't struggle or you'll fall.
No, but that's what you crave. The struggle.
I know men like you. Bye, Bat.
Step out of the shadows and be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
Well then. Time to save the city.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. For too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. And together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Welcome to Wayne Manor, everyone. My apologies for the late arrival.
Oh, not to worry, Mr. Wayne. We've all made ourselves very comfortable. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you? I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle. So the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Just working the night shift.
Yeah, well, then you're pulling a double.
No one came here tonight to see me.
Some champagne.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent." We're the grease, they're the wheels.
A little liquid courage before facing your adoring public.
This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign.
Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those.
It always makes me sound like a used car salesman.
All right. How about, a new face for Gotham,
Look at you. It's not half bad. I'm gonna use that.
Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, Come on. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to
Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, thank you. But we're all here tonight because we want to make a difference. And that's what it's going to take. Every single one of us. Not just me, not just Mr. Dent. Everyone.
Right. Of course.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbox are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman.
Well, I have to say I side with your wife on this, Mr. Zellerbach. Even a spark of hope can light the darkness.
Oh, an idealist with a bank account. He'll be broke before election day.
And I know Bruce would gladly spend every penny he has to fix this city. I don't doubt that for a moment. Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. With Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne, in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible, truly terrible.
Tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, thank you. I wish my parents could be here speaking with you too.
And thank you, Bruce, for investing in the health of this city's future.
You have our support, Mr. Dent. Go get him.
We're on our way. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Hello. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
Well, he certainly doesn't have any time either.
No, it's all right. You can stay.
Thanks.
Bruce?
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Well, I'm doing better now that you're here. I'll tell you, if all these stuffed shirts weren't around, I'd give you the private tour.
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Spilled some wine. It'll come out.
Stick to clear alcohols, Bruce. They never stain.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
I don't like this, Harv, but I'm trusting you.
Thank you, Bruce. Seriously. You know I have to pull every string I can to get elected.
Yeah, well, just make sure this one doesn't hang you.
A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
Let's talk privately, shall we?
I like this guy. Ready to do business before we even introduce ourselves. But we'll get to that. Carmine Falcone, thank you for welcoming me into your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Bruce Wayne.
I know who you are. The guy is going to sell me his house.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple with Mayor Hill.
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say? Mr. District Attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will. The man talks too much, chaps my face with words.
Well, I would say you can uphold the law and still do what's right.
To a point. No one gets remembered for staying in the middle.
Mr. Falcone, I...
No more warnings. I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me indigestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me. Be a pal. I can get Harvey the mayor's seat, or I can pull it out from under him. Whatever happened to being a gracious host? Okay, imagine, this is me, and these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home, hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light, if need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Hey, this isn't a deal with the devil. You listen to me, kid. I know, somewhere inside that tuxedo, you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Don't you dare talk about my father.
You're getting worked up over nothing. Hell, I knew him longer than you did. People don't say no to me. Not for long.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Heed your butler's advice, kid. Oh, and I'm no longer interested in buying the house. The owner's a prick, and he's gonna get what's coming to him.
It's me.
Another brutal week in Gotham, folks. A string of home invasions ripple through the city's already crime-infested East End. Apparently, the bandits are using stolen GCPD battery rams to force their way in, with break-in and entry incidents up 40% over last year. Remember to keep those front doors locked tonight. And we have breaking news tonight. Five criminals are in custody this evening after a break-in at City Hall. But thanks to the efforts of the Batman, the stolen items were returned.
Not all of them. Let's see what she was really after.
Allegations that Dent may have actually been involved in the break-in. Talk about dirty politics. Does Hill's campaign really think these accusations hold any water with the voters? Or will it be perceived as a desperate attempt from a flailing campaign to take down one of Gotham's most promising young politicians?
And in other news, we are now on day 3 of the factory fire that will not end. Crews have given up trying to combat the blaze at the oldest...
Nearly fell off a building for this?
Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning in there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at it. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek immediate treatment if you happen to breathe in any of that tar black smoke.
And one mobster's murder...
Spare grapple. Can't believe I let her take that.
Family capo, Louis Pistachio Garmone, was found hanging off the side of...
I should see if I can refine the edge. Could be sharper.
...causing traffic to back up for miles as the cops cut him down.
Well, the test run at the mayor's office was a success. Can deliver a jolt or knock out electricity in the area. I suppose that Catwoman would have preferred the latter. The newest addition can program it to reveal trace elements in a confined space.
While most have been admitted to Gotham General in critical condition, the police don't have any suspects at the time. Two more patients have gone missing from Arkham Asylum, bringing the total number of escapees from the half-prison, half-mental hospital to 15 this year. Only 3 have been caught today, but all the escapees highlight the rough, some would say inhumane, conditions at the Aegean Asylum. The latest, 44-year-old twin brother...
Let's find out what was so important.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here, in a dark, damp cave, in front of a computer.
I'll leave as soon as I finish. People with regular jobs can do their work anywhere, but for me, this is my office.
I agree. It isn't normal work. Even worse, the best outcome is that no one ever finds out you've done it.
Yeah, well, good deeds usually go unnoticed.
Though not unappreciated. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
Well, in the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle. This is a map of the East Side shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone.
Before the game switched from billiards to cuts.
I'd recommend leaving the fist fights to your alter ego.
Yeah, thanks for the interruption.
Well, it wasn't for you, Bruce. I was worried I might drink all my good scotch.
For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
I've never seen her before. Hopefully, she's just a tourist. No, I already checked the codex.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
That's not the point. I want criminals to know I'm out there. Batman isn't hiding from anybody.
I was talking about Bruce. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I've had to cover for mysterious injuries before.
You've been lucky.
Or I'm just a really good liar.
A necessary evil in your line of work, I suppose. Though I hope you change careers someday. Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse. One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I... Haven't the faintest idea.
You think he's looking for a handout?
He would have come to the right person.
No, because I'm...
Because you're generous. A little too much sometimes, with your wealth, your time, and even your well-being. Even though you and young Master Cobblepot used to be close, I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
I'll be careful, Alfred.
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
Where are you, Oz?
Thank you, sir.
Statue, but no Oz. Hey.
Beat it. Watch, wallet, cash. But this goes through you. Hey, you heard him, man. The hell are you waiting for?
Go ahead. Try and take it.
The hell do you say? End him!
Gentlemen!
Oz.
Keep walking, all right?
This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do. And you're ruining the moment! Come here! Think that'll do? Stay down! Used to be a nice place. Lowlifes like you don't belong. This is my park! Mine! You hear that?
Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, there. Good as new. Woo! That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
Hey, I could have handled that myself.
You mean a knife handle in the back? Because that's what would have happened, mate. No offense.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, it's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
This place is a wreck. It's better off bulldozed.
This park still matters to me, Bruce. It's all my folks left behind. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham.
Dad
ended it yourself, he did.
My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential.
Well, that's just the way it goes sometimes. It's out of our control.
Well, obviously, but you don't have to be a dick about it.
You know, when I saw you at the party last night, I thought, Bruce Wayne. Has it changed a bit?
Maybe I was wrong.
Shouldn't have been a surprise when I saw you with Carmine Falcone. Made himself right at home. That oily...
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. Never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Falcone made a stack of cash and corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine.
All he needs is a little push. And... it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement.
Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, though. A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
Are you threatening me, Oz?
Take it as you like.
I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you.
When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
Mr. Wayne, over here, right here.
This way.
Bruce, Bruce!
Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars?
I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. We didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. And worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. And Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
My parents loved Gotham. They invested their blood, sweat, and tears in this city. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. My parents were heroes that night, and we can all learn from their sacrifice.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
I say we leave the asylum standing as a reminder that we can do better. This time we won't fail those who need us most. All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You even shook his hand.
I don't make friends with gangsters. He was an unwelcome guest. That's all. Next question, please.
Please keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
How dare you? I just finished telling you about my parents' murder and you accuse them of being, what, criminals? Have some decency.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What aren't you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
All right, this press conference is over.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What aren't you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage control's my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile. Hopefully we can do our job and be out of here ASAP.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And if I refuse?
Well, then we might have to make a scene. That's the last thing I want. But orders are orders, and this one comes from the top. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots. So, consider yourself served. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's chopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Stay back!
Take whatever you want!
You don't have to do this!
Bruce? I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
This is the second time you've shown up uninvited.
Well, it's difficult to book a meeting with you.
Well, I enjoy my privacy.
Enjoyed. Past tense. Sorry, but if the press has their way, you're not gonna have any for a while. Listen, Bruce, a scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Carmine Falcone wants me to be in his pocket. He crashed Harvey's fundraiser and pretty much said, hop in.
Well, maybe he thinks putting a little fear in you will make you jump.
It won't.
By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
Turn it off, Miss Vale.
Oh, but Bruce...
Until I know what's really going on, I am not speaking to the press again.
You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vale.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family? We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
Warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning?
I'm in a lot of trouble, Harvey. and I need your help to get me out of it.
Yes, of course. Of course, whatever I can do. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah. Then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this. I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it.
You owe me an explanation.
And I will get you one. Straight from Mayor Hill's mouth. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
That is exactly what I intend to find out.
Easy, Bruce. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
We need to fight back. Hill cannot get away with this.
It may not be a war we can win.
The city will be behind you, Harvey, just like I am.
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being late.
No, just glad you made it.
You didn't tell me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selena.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
I think we've met before.
You do look familiar.
Everyone knows who Bruce Wayne is.
Do they?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Selena's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
How'd you get that shiner?
Bruce?
It's okay. Money doesn't buy manners, right? I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
Well, that's terrible. Did they catch the guy?
Not yet. But if they don't, I will.
It's probably long gone by now. Whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Oh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye.
So, what do you do for a living?
It's complicated. High risk, high reward.
Ah, stock market, huh?
Something like that. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
Nice to meet the real you.
Likewise.
This explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention, everyone in this cafe.
Sorry about the black eye.
It's not the first time a man's hit me.
Sorry to hear that.
Don't worry. I'm not gonna expose you. Yet. I'm curious about something, though. I do what I do for money, but you're... Bruce Wayne. What's your excuse? I have to. But you, why take the risk?
I think you know enough already. The rest is my secret.
And here I was thinking we were starting to get somewhere. How disappointing. You have something that belongs to me. I want it back. This is awkward for me.
As I recall, you took something from me, too. Hope you're getting some use out of that grappling gun.
I'm more interested in how I can use you. These people I'm working for, they don't screw around. If I fail to deliver that drive, it's gonna cost a lot more than money.
Well, looks like you've made your bed.
No, we've made this bed, and I'm not gonna lie in it alone. You owe me. If they don't get what they want, there will be consequences. I don't like consequences. In fact, I spend most of my time avoiding them. Listen, I don't have a lot of time. My employer is expecting me to drop it off.
Where?
Just give it back.
The address, now.
No, give me the drive.
You are really starting to piss me off.
Oh, there you are. I was hoping you'd come out and play.
Write it down. Now.
My contact. He'll be expecting a cat, not a bat.
When are you supposed to meet him?
15 minutes ago. Better hurry.
Everything okay here?
You tell me.
I have my people working on it. We're gonna straighten everything out.
I feel better already. Sorry, but I've gotta run.
So soon? Aren't you gonna stay for a drink?
Yeah, Bruce. Stay for a drink?
I'd love to, but I've got another appointment and I really don't want to be late for it.
Oh, all right then. Don't forget to change into your suit.
Alfred, I'm at the warehouse. No sign of Catwoman's contact. It's quiet.
The sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good Lord. Who could have done such a thing?